Hello, my name is Travis Leglider. I'm the weed science specialist at Purdue University under the direction of Bill Johnson. Today I will be talking to you about Palmer amaranth and specifically the identification of Palmer amaranth seedlings. Palmer amaranth is one of the newest weeds in Indiana. It was discovered last fall in northwestern Indiana. It is a problematic weed that's very difficult to manage and a weed that Purdue Weed Science wants producers to be aware of. We want them to be aware of where it's at and how to identify it. The proper identification of Palmer amaranth is key to management of this weed. We observed at our Cass County site on May 20th that Palmer amaranth was emerging, giving us indication that Palmer amaranth was more than likely emerging in other parts of the state as well. On May 29th, the Palmer at that site had reached a 2 to 3 leaf stage. This was over 9 days of fairly cool and wet weather, showing the aggressiveness of this weed even in cool and wet weather. 3 weeks after planting, this is a picture of Palmer amaranth at that site with soybeans, and as you can see, without a pre-emerge, this weed emerges very quickly and competes very quickly with the soybeans. This is a population that would need to be sprayed within the next week for proper management with a post application. So identification at this stage is very critical. So across the state right now, this is a time when producers need to be identifying whether or not they have Palmer amaranth in their fields. The producers who need to be looking out for Palmer amaranth, we'd like everybody in Indiana to be looking out for it, but the producers in the red counties need to be on the high alert, on the lookout, as these are counties that have either had Palmer confirmed in them or have a county adjacent to them that has had Palmer identified in them. So just because the producer has not seen Palmer before in their field doesn't mean it's not going to be there this year. It can spread by wildlife, equipment, and other means. Now, whenever producers go to identify what pigweeds are in their fields, the first thing we want them to look at is look for fine hairs on the stem and leaf surfaces. On these plants, you can see the fine hairs here along the stem as well as up here on the leaf surface on that leaf margin on this plant as well. These are red root and smooth pigweed. If you find the fine hairs, you know that you have the red root or smooth pigweed. If you do not find the hairs on the plant, you know that you have either water hemp or Palmer amaranth. Now, water hemp and Palmer amaranth are very difficult to differentiate even at a small stage, even by trained weed scientists. So a few things we want you to look for at these small stages to differentiate common water hemp and Palmer amaranth. Now, common water hemp is gonna have these long linear leaves, much longer and linear than what you're gonna find on Palmer amaranth. If you look in the leaf tip notches of these plants, you will not find the little hairs that we'll find in Palmer amaranth that we'll show you a little bit later. There will not be a singular hair in those leaf tip notches. And the other thing and the big thing between these two species is the petiole length. If we look down, kind of down in there, on these first true leaves, you'll see those petioles are rather short, and these plants, rather than extending their petioles, extend the leaf blade itself rather than the petioles. So common water hemp has the short petioles, lacks the singular hairs in the leaf tip notch, and has the long linear leaves as compared to Palmer amaranth. On Palmer amaranth, if we look at the first, second, and third true leaves, within one of those leaves and those leaf tip notches, you will find a single hair. This has been very common and very consistent across the populations that we have in Indiana that we have observed. It's not going to be on all the leaves and not on all the plants, but if you look through your plants and find on the first, second, or third true leaf this small hair protruding from the leaf tip notch, you have a very high likelihood of Palmer amaranth as compared to common water hemp. The next thing and the big thing we like to look for is the petiole length of that first true leaf. So here we have two plants that were growing in the greenhouse. They are at the 3 to 4 true leaf stage. And as we look here at that first true leaf and look at that petiole. So that petiole is that structure that connects the leaf blade to the stem itself. You can see that petiole and that first true leaf is extending out there, extending that leaf blade out from underneath the shadow of those second, third, and fourth true leaves. So this is a big key, looking at the petiole length on the first true leaf. So we can see this on both of these plants with those long petioles. Now, here's some pictures in the field at Cass County. So here's a plant that it's at about the, has one, two, maybe three true leaves on it, but definitely two true leaves, and it's already extending out those first true leaves on that long petiole. Now, if you looked at our publication that we just recently released, we talk about that petiole length and how to compare it to the leaf blade itself, and we showed you how to do it on older plants, and the same holds true on these younger plants. We plucked off that first true leaf, bent that petiole back over the leaf blade itself, and as you can see, that petiole is longer than the leaf blade itself. So the extension of the petiole in that first true leaf is a big indicator to us of Palmer amaranth. So just to review really quickly, Palmer amaranth identification, it's going to lack hairs on the stem and leaf surfaces. You're going to find a singular hair in the leaf tip notch on either the first, second, or third true leaf. You're not going to find it on every leaf, but on one of those leaves, you will find that singular hair in the leaf tip notch, at least in the populations we have in here in Indiana. The big thing is the extension of the petiole of those first true leaves out from underneath the shadows of those second, third, and fourth true leaves. And as they extend those petioles, as we look down on top of that growing point, you will see a nice rosette shape as those petioles even themselves out. Now, if you want more information on Palmer amaranth, on its biology, identification, management, this is our newest publication, our newest Purdue publication, WS51. It covers Palmer amaranth. You can find this at the Purdue Education Store. The address for that is this address here for the Purdue Education Store, or you can go directly to this publication for your free download at this link right here. Now, if you think you have Palmer amaranth, or if you have Palmer amaranth questions, or have pictures that you would like Bill or I to look at, feel free to give us a call. Feel free to send us an email at the following email and phone numbers. Thank you, and have a good day.